Hello everyone, we'll be starting the webinar in just a minute. Before we do that, if you can just type in the chat box if you can hear me. I've done webinars for an hour without people hearing me, so we want to avoid that from happening. Awesome. Awesome, getting a lot of yeses. All right, so now you guys should also see my screen. Just a few seconds. All right, you should have it now. So thank you for attending this today's webinar. And today's webinar, our goal is to essentially go over the new functions and features that were released last night. Last night we did have a release, for essentially all clients who are considered as our live client, our main client base. And with this release, we've released some really good features that I know a lot of you guys have asked for. All of these features are actually exactly from the feedbacks that you guys have provided to us in the past. So once again, feedbacks are very important. Please make sure that you continue providing feedback. You can provide feedback by either A, going to this under your name here on the right hand side and clicking the feedback button, or to our Facebook page through emails to support. Really any path that you you would like the best. But please make sure that you do provide feedback for any existing features that we have, if you would like to see enhancements on it, or if there are any new features that you believe it could help yourself or others. We would always like to hear your, essentially opinion, so we can build the product that works best for you. Now the features today, once again, have been built based around the feedbacks that you have provided to us. One of the feedbacks that we've been getting over the years is managing families. Managing families has always been a trouble. You have a family of four people, five people come into the business and would like to buy memberships, or you would like to create that connection between each member, so you know who is related to who, what are the relationships, and be able to conduct different things. In some cases, a parent comes and asks you, what are, all the payments on my accounts? And because the payments are on multiple accounts, it would be tougher for you to be able to tell as a business owner. So you had to previously go to from one contact to another. Now, this could be payments, maybe ranks, the same thing. What are my, students and members ranked at, or what level they're in their training, or how many attendances they had, what was their last attendance? A variety of different circumstances that comes up. In addition to that, it also relates to communication, to online purchases. It really affects all different aspects of the business. So, managing the families has been one of our top priorities. We have plans to improve the family memberships and family connections within the next few months. Today, we're going to go over the first phase of the changes that we released. So you typically, when you're creating, want to manage a family, you start from one contact. So either it's one of the children or the parent that you already have as a lead or as a student in your, in your PerfectMIND system. The second action that you would like to take typically would be to add the additional family members. So previously, in order to do that, you had to go into the contacts section and create a new lead, or create a new contact every single time and re-enter a lot of the duplicated information. For those of you who were a little bit more savvy, you would use the clone button to be able to clone this profile and change some of the information. Now the clone button is good, it does save time, but it wasn't really perfect. It did carry some information over that we didn't want to carry over, and it just was not built for this purpose in specific. So what we've done to improve that, we've now created this little section on the left hand side so you can manage the families a lot better. The first step, it starts from adding new family members. So let's say we want to create Bruce Lee's, or add Bruce Lee's family to file. So what you would do, you would click on this button where it says add a family member, and you would get the following option. It would say, all right, you want to add a family member. So choose one of the following actions. Is it an existing contact that's already on your file that you want to connect this person to as a family member, or do you want to create a new contact? For our purposes today, we would, you know, click the new contact. So what that does, it creates you an open sheet for you to be able to add a new contact to the system. It would also carry over some of the information for you. It would carry over the home address. It would carry over the home phone. We didn't have a home phone recorded for privacy. We had the mobile, but if it was marked as a home phone, it would have been carried over as well. We carry over the email and, you know, obviously information like last name. And also, it would automatically link the family member for you as well. So you could, you know, easily, you know, add the new family basically member. So I would just type in the name. I would make some of the changes if there are necessary, and I would press save. So right away when, you know, completing this action, now going to the new contact that I've added, you see now there is a relationship between that person and the original contact that I, you know, started from. If I click on the original contact, you would see the same thing. The new record that we've added has been, you know, linked to as part of that family and as a relationship between the two. Now, you know, creating that record, you know, we know it was a trouble for you and it was a challenge for you. So we tried to first, you know, attack that and tackle that problem for you. But the second problem is now defining the relationships. It's always best for you as a business owner to have enough information possible so you can make good decisions and you can, you know, sound, and when communicating to your contacts, you can essentially sound educated about the relationships. So the second part after adding a new contact to a family is defining the relationship between one another. So we added Lisa to, you know, as to the family for the Lee family under Bruce Lee. So the second part is adding a relation. So here we have actually have a link under each one of the contacts that are defined in that family. And here you are able to actually define the relationship between each of the contacts. So for example, in this case, we would click on this field and it allows us to pick from one of the relationships that we've already predefined for you, or, you know, you can create your own records and information as well in case you want to, you know, we missed one of the relationships that you want to manage. So in this case, let's say, you know, basically Lisa is a sister, and, you know, basically you can do that with all the other contacts as well. So this way you can have a much more accurate list. All right, easy enough. So now this wasn't actually your only feedback. So we've now covered how to add a new contact to a family, so, and, you know, speed up the process for you, defining your relationship. But the other thing that, you know, it came up quite often is dealing with financial information. So in the past, when you actually had a family, what you had to do, you know, when you wanted to actually add financial information, you had to add the credit card number for each individual contact that you had. So the sister had to have a credit card, the, you know, father had to have a credit card, and the brother had to have the credit card. Now, this is obviously not the regular business case. You know, usually most families, people share the same credit card information. So if, you know, the daughter wants to purchase a bottle of water or uniform, they would probably want to use the same credit card that the father has. So what you're able to do in those cases, you're able to, you know, go into an existing financial information or create a new one. And during that process, what you're able to do is to mark this checkbox where it says share with family. Upon checking this box, this credit card now will be made available during checkout for any of those contacts that are under that family. So this again will speed up your general process of, you know, managing your contacts. So let's go back here. So we've now have the financial information added, and on the, this financial information has now been marked as shared with family. All right. Now the other thing is also very important when dealing with families is defining who's the primary contact. And this comes handy for a variety of reasons. For you to being able to, you know, have marketing communication, for you to be able to follow up with certain people, and also for you providing access and login credentials for one main person so they can manage all family members within one online member account. So we have added another checkbox here on the contact called primary contact. Now, if you are creating a family for the first time, this checkbox does get checked automatically for you. For cases that, you know, and this gets checked based on the first original contact that you've added. So I've added the father first, and as I'm adding new family members, the original contact that I started from will automatically be marked as primary contact. But if you don't wish for that to be the case, or you want to make a change to that, you can also manually adjust that value. So now, this person, in this case Bruce, is the primary contact for that family. So what that means is Bruce can actually use his member login when he goes to your website to, you know, interact with, you know, purchasing memberships or purchasing products, and you know, he can choose which member of the family they want to make that purchase for. Or the same goes if Bruce is going online to check their financial information, the history of the accounts. He can actually check the history and the information for every one of the family members. All right, we're actually not done yet with the family function. There's a couple more things that I want to discuss. The second thing is, you know, the actual family itself. So as I mentioned, you know, in some cases you would have a parent come to you and would ask information about, all right, you know, what's going on with my family? When was the last attendance? What emails have you sent me? What is the last transaction that we've had with you? Or whatever the case is. So for every actually family, we have a family page as well. We had this in the past as well, but we just made it, you know, you can access it still using the same family link that we had before or using this new family section on the left-hand side. So if I want to see a family's account details, I can click on the family name, and that will take me to the family profile. So what's different about family profile versus the contact profile is that it contains all the contacts and all the information of every single family member under that family. So, you know, basically you would see all the contacts, you would see all the activities that has been done with all the family members, you would see, you know, all the emails and so on and so forth, you know, all the information that you have. So if I'm looking at attendance, I see, okay, one family member attending at this time, and the other one, this is a very good, sophisticated family with Jean-Claude Van Damme and Bruce Lee in the same family, so it's a family you don't want to mess with. But, in you know, you would see all the information at the same time. So this, essentially what it does, it gives you more information, so as you're communicating with your, you know, members, you're able to provide right information to them. And also provide the information faster to them. Now, I'm going to just show you guys one other thing which we previously discussed, and that is sharing the login credential, or sorry, sharing the financial information, since I didn't actually show it to you guys on the and how we'll look during the checkout screen. So, as you guys remember, we went into one of the financial informations that's under Bruce in this case, and we clicked Share with Family. So what we can do now, we can go into our new contact that we've added, which is Lisa, and let's sell her a membership. So click on the membership, we choose one of the memberships, and let's give it the down payment as well, so it becomes easier for our example. So as I'm choosing credit card to process this down payment with, as you see, it shows me already a credit card number. And in brackets, it shows that it's shared, meaning that this is coming from another family member. If Lisa also had some credit cards on her own file, you would also see the rest of the credit cards without the word shared in the brackets. So this, again, improves the process of you making a sale. Now, this sale could be a membership, it could be a product, or it could be an event. But in all cases, you can still make that sale under the right contact so you know what contact purchased what products or memberships, but still improve the, and make the process more efficient by, you know, not having the, you know, or needing to re-enter the credit card information. All right, that covers all that we have for the family members or the family functions and family enhancements. Having said that, once again, this is only the phase one. We actually have multiple other phases planned and scheduled that's going to come in, you know, 2015 for improving the family functions even more. And there's a lot of exciting stuff coming on that end as well. Alright, so the next feature that we've released is kind of like an enhancement, and that was again based on the feedbacks that you guys had submitted to us. When you know, one of the common practices in majority of the businesses, you know, from a martial arts school, a yoga studio, dance studio, is being able to print certain information for your contacts. Now, the information that was always basically we receive feedback on to improve the process on is printing information such as, let's say, barcode labels or address labels or even printing ID cards for attendants. So usually, you know, if you want to print it in-house and you don't want to go to, you know, a printing manufacturer to print key tags and things like that, you would, you know, probably buy, you know, cardstock papers or Avery type papers. So Avery is a brand. They have, but you know, different types of papers that, you know, are out there. Usually they're, essentially stickers, you know, formed on the paper using a certain arrangement. So, you know, 2 columns by 10 or 3 columns by 10, so on and so forth. And upon printing these barcodes or these labels, you are able to peel off the ones that you printed. So the problem that, you know, some of you guys were facing is that, all right, you buy, let's say, an address label paper. So this is an Avery paper, let's say, you know, and all the Avery numbers, if you guys are not familiar with it, they have a number associated with it. So for example, Avery 08920, it's a template for 3x10, which can be used for address labels. So you can print 30 address labels on one sheet. But the issue was that in some cases, you were only printing these address labels for, let's say, 10 people. Now you had a piece of paper that, you know, 10 of these stickers were peeled off, and you were still remaining with, you know, the next 20. The challenge was that, you know, you didn't really have an easy way for you to just reuse that existing paper that you've already used part of it. So you either A, had to, you know, update your merge documents to, you know, fit the new page and what's remaining from the page, or you had to, you know, basically start fresh with a brand new sheet. Obviously, not the best thing to do. So we wanted to actually improve that for you. So moving forward, when you are selecting multiple contacts and you want to print a document, now this document, if it's under, you know, two of the folders that we believe, you know, you would use and you would use an Avery paper for, either the ID card folder or label folder. So if you are printing any document under these folders, you would see this screen. This screen, essentially what it does, it asks you what page type you're using. So you can say, I'm using Avery 08460, which is 3x10, or I'm using, you know, Avery 08371, which is 2x5. Now, there are equivalent papers to this as well. These are not the only types, so you could find other Avery papers equivalent to 08460, which is the same exact formation. But upon, you know, you selecting this, you are able to, you know, select where you want to print this document from. So this way you can reuse an existing paper that you have already on file. You don't have to, you know, buy a new page or, you know, use a new sheet. You could save trees, save some money, and, you know, still be able to complete the tasks that you have in hand. Now, this works in two ways. You can either use a contact section and you can select the, you know, again, the number of contacts you want. And as I showed you, press print and choose any of the items that are on the list. Or you are also able to do this, you know, using the document app itself. So you can go into manage document. You can, select the document that you have. And you can select the records that you want to have. So this could be used if you are using, you want to print these labels for other items like products or, you know, basically employees and whatnot. So what you would have to do in those cases, do you select essentially the main merge object. So this is the section that you want to have. So in this case, products, you would select the records, and the same process if your document is saved under labels or, you know, ID cards, the same options will appear to you. All right, I did get a couple of questions. I'm just going to hold off to it. We're going to go, you know, at the end of this webinar, we would have time for, you know, basically questions and answers, and I'll be happy to answer all the questions. All right, so this covers essentially how to printing and managing ID cards and barcode labels or address labels or really any other document that you might use a similar type of sheets for. Now, one of the other features that we've improved on this release is improving the checkout process. That's specifically the online checkout process. We received quite a bit of feedback on this feature and on, you know, on enhancing this feature. So in the past, you know, when you had, you know, essentially a product or an event or a membership that you made available online to purchase, you know, and as people were making the purchase, they had two options before adding their credit card number. And that option was either A, to sign up. So, you know, they're either new to your site, so they had to put in a certain information to sign up for, and get a new member account. And this is a login credentials that would be used for your website. And also, you know, that action would have lead them to, or would have had PerfectMIND to create a new lead for you in the system as well. Or they had an option to log in. So maybe they're returning users and returning members, sorry, and you know they already have a login credentials that they could have used to log into your site and complete that action. And that action, again, is either booking for an event or purchasing a product or membership. So we've tried to improve that because what you've noticed and what you have actually brought to our attention is that, you know, upon some of these processes, as your student is going online or as your member is going online to complete this action, they would either A, not remember their login credentials, or they're trying to sign up and they would get errors because maybe that email address is already being used. Anyways, it would have created a lot of headache for them. So these headaches would have caused essentially, you know, for you to lose that sale because, you know, if I'm trying to actually purchase something online and I get into errors a couple of times in a row, I would probably give up. So we tried to improve that. We tried to make it easier for your members to actually complete that action. And so you can, you know, be sure that you get essentially that booking or that purchase, and you can deal with the rest yourself. And this is, again, for us to be able to improve the purchase process. Another thing with that we resolved, you know, or the first thing that we resolved with that is, in the past, we had the functionality that an email address can be used, you know, only once within the PerfectMIND clients. Let me just elaborate more on that. So if you know, as a yoga studio, let's say, that me as a student, so I'm Nima, is going to a certain yoga studio, and I already have a login credentials with that yoga studio to access their website. What we had as a challenge is that, you know, if I am also attending a martial arts school in the same area, I would not be able to use the same exact email address during the sign-up process because that email address was already being used on the PerfectMIND system. We've improved that, first of all, so that email address now can be used within the multiple businesses without causing any issues. So that was the first step that we took. The second step is improving the overall process as well. So what if, you know, I don't want to sign up, you know, during that process. So let's go, you know, I'm on the actual public site of the website. So as, you know, a member that's just coming to your website. So you either A, has sent me a direct link to a certain product or membership or an event for me to purchase, or, you know, I'm just coming to your website, browsing to your social site. I find a product that I like, and I click the Buy Now button. So now, moving forward, you'll see this new screen. This new screen has, you know, kind of a different option. So instead of allowing you to sign up or sign in, it gives you the option to either log in using, you know, the returning customer section on the right-hand side, or continue as a guest. So what the continue as a guest function is an ability for you to, or for the member to complete that action without really going through the sign-up process. So they can put in the credit card right away. They can put their name, you know, all that information, even their email address. And all this information is required because you want to, you know, obviously have a legit sale that's not going to come back. So upon completing these information, you know, I'm pressing, you know, place my order, the sale will be done. The credit card will be charged if there is a fee associated to it. and you will still get that new lead. So that information will be still saved on your PerfectMIND account. So you're not going to miss anything. You're not going to lose on a new business, new customer, new fees. All of that, it's going to be worked in the background. But what we do also do, we give the option for people, this is an optional field, to create a password as well if they wish to check out faster next time. So they don't have to do this, but they are able to do this if they wish. So, you know, as I'm putting the information, I can also put in a password that I would like, and the system will create me a login credential, so I will be emailed that login credential. So next time when I want to make a purchase, I don't have to choose the option, continue as a guest. I can just choose the option returning as a customer. But in case, and this apparently happens often, if I still don't remember my login credential, I can still continue as a guest, even if I have a login. The system is not going to produce any errors. The system is not going to stop me from completing that action, because it is important for us to ensure that that booking or that purchase is made for your business, so you are and you can benefit from it. All right. Now, having said that, you know, this could potentially cause some duplicates for you. Would be rare, but it is possible. Now, that's okay. If that happens, we have already made it easy for you to be able to manage that. One, we have a view for you created called Find Duplicates. So this can mark the duplicates for you of which people we believe are duplicates. Now, sometimes this field or this view is not able to catch all duplicates because they might use complete different names, right? And there's no way for us to connect the two together. But if even you notice yourself that there are two duplicated contacts in your system, you're able to just select those two people or multiple people and click the merge contacts. What this does, essentially, will merge those two contacts together to as one. And actually, their login credentials will work, even both their login credentials, the one they had from the past or the one they, you know, created in future. All their financial history, financial information, credit cards, all of that information will be merged, so you will not lose any information. All right. So that covers essentially the guest checkout function. The last enhancements that we have, it's only applicable for some of you in this room today, but it is for the Mr. Marketer clients. This enhancements that we have is for you as a, you know, Mr. Marketer client to be able to utilize all the landing pages that we built. We have certain landing pages that have this buy now function. So these are usually the quick start landing pages. Again, this is only applicable to right now to the martial art clients. But these landing pages that do have the buy now buttons, what the challenge was for some of you was that you were not able to use it because you were not using a billing system. Maybe you had all your billing as in-house. Now, there are not a big percentage of people like that, but there are some. So what we wanted to do, we wanted to make sure that you, as you know, an active client, still have the ability to utilize these landing pages and these information. So what we've done now, this is something in the background, but we have now an ability for us to swap this buy now button for you to just a form. So you don't, you know, you can still continue using these forms and these landing pages and these emails that are associated to Mr. Marketer. So you are still able to actually take advantage of these pages even though you're not using the billing system. So this is just a quick note, quick enhancements. If you fall under that category and you had those emails or landing pages shut off, you are able to contact us again and we are able to activate it for you. All right. This covers really majority of the features that were worth mentioning. We do have releases again next month, and we will be covering more functions on those releases. At this point, I can go to questions. I do see I have a few questions, so I'll start from there. All right, so Terry has asked, can you sell products and membership and et cetera to two family members at the same time using the shared visa, or do you have to do each student separately? Terry, very, very good question. Right now, at this point, you would have to make those transactions separately. Now, the positive thing is moving forward, as of this release, you don't have to add the financial information for the second time. You can just add it once. Now, as I mentioned earlier, we're just on the phase one of the family enhancements. Actually, the phase two of enhancements is the function that you just mentioned. So it gives you the ability to make multiple transactions for multiple people during the same checkout. That's what is coming up in in early 2015. So for now, we have just improved that process, but we're delivering exactly what you're asking for right now. It's actually in development. All right. So let me just go back to the questions. Terry has asked, can you make the country and region default to US when using the shopping cart? Not at this time. And it is also not a common practice for the checkout process, because the checkout is something that, you would have to actually ask people to put in their information. So, right now, certainly doesn't have that functionality, but it is also not a common practice, at least for online checkout, for those information to be filled out. It's something that, because even, if I'm living in the United States, my billing address could be different. So it is an information that you should ask. The country and region is relatively easy to pick, though, since it's pickless, but, hopefully that, satisfies your need at this time. All right, Ned has asked, what information takes priority in merge? Example address, is there a conflict? Very good question, Ned. So, the merge functionality essentially utilizes priority based on the contact type. So that's the first thing. So, for example, if you're merging a lead to a student, the student takes priority, and all the information of the student takes first priority. So if both the lead and the student have email addresses, we're going to use the student email address first. We're going to still record the lead email address as an activity, but we're not going to use it as a primary value. This goes along with all the other information. So, same thing with address, last name, so on and so forth. The other information that's important is, or in the case that you have two students, let's say now, so you have two contacts, both of them are students. In those cases, the priority is put based upon, which person is more active. So the person with more transactions, more attendance records, and things like that. The logic is essentially, we've tried to take in consideration all those business cases to make sure that we merge it properly. Now, having said that, all the information that we were not able to merge from, the additional contacts is saved under activity. So you can always go back and find out what information was not merged and make changes yourself. I'm going to make a big note here now. Upon completing a merge, you can't go back. So please make sure when you are merging, you do merge the information correctly and you merge the right contacts. The button that's marked as merge contacts is that button that allows you to merge two people. When you click this button, there is already a warning message as well. So, we try to warn you as much as possible before you making this action. Now, this button, which kind of answers one of the other questions that we have, if you don't see this button is only available for the global admins within your database. So it's only available for the owners, for the main managers. We didn't want to make this available to all staff members because mistakes can happen. Right, we don't want that to happen, especially we don't want to put your business through that. So Aubrey, you had asked a question about find duplicate button. So that's probably the case. You probably are not a global admin. If you are and you still don't see it, I would recommend contacting support. Sherman has asked, I have a brother and a sister. Can you link it now? Yeah, of course. Again, you would go into one of the contacts. You would click add a family member. In this case, I'm assuming you already have that the both brother and the sister, in your system. So you would click existing contact. You would select, bring Jetly to this family as well, and then you would mark that person with that relationship. So now Jetly and Bruce Lee are brothers. different spelling of these, but who cares? And then, you know, you can mark them as the relationship as well. Justin has asked, if you sell a family pass to multiple members when you registered them as attended, will all of them show up with an heart? So Justin, right now you would have to sell a membership per contact. So if there's a family coming into lessons at your business, you would sell a membership for the brother, another membership for the father, and another membership for the sister. So and then all of them will show up with a heart in front of their name. Now, in future, you're able to do that in the one step. So you're able to sell one membership called family membership, and during checkout, you can say, I want to give access to classes to this person using this program, this person, this person. So we want to make that even that process easier. Now, for financial cases, if you are selling multiple memberships to multiple family members today, the memberships don't have to have a fee associated to them. Memberships, you know, the first person, maybe the father or the primary contact, can have all the financials under that person. The rest of them could have a $0 membership. That membership will just define to the system of what type of access they should have and what classes they should attend. I hope that answers your question. Dustin Fee has asked, one common complaint I get with families of 3 or 4 receiving the exact same Mr. Marketer email 3 or 4 times. Is there a way to streamline this? Dustin, we've already corrected this. Now, so if you are still getting that and received that in the past couple months, if you can send me a quick email, my email is nima@championsway.com. Maybe list the person that has mentioned that to you. Because as long as there is the same email account used for each one of the for the entire family or for all the family members. So let's say bruce.lee@perfectminddemo.com is being used for all the families because that's the father's link. The system is smart enough to make sure that email only goes out once, and that's using this function. Sent to email address once. So this is already checked for all the Mr. Market emails. This was the feature that we released about a couple months ago. So after that, all the emails have been corrected to utilize this. So if this is still happening, if you can send me an email with the names of those contacts that have experienced this, so I can take a look and give you a better answer of what the case could be. I would have to do a little bit more troubleshooting. Maybe they have different email addresses or a case like that. Oh, no problem, no problem. So, again, if that is still coming up, in the past 2 months, definitely let me know and I'll check into it. So, Briscoe has asked, what do I have to do to set up the Buy Now link if I am in UK? So, Mr. Briscoe, we do have a UK partner for billing as well, for specifically credit cards. So, first, it would have to start with a merchant account if you want to use the Buy Now button. And then, upon having the merchant account, we are able to basically activate those emails. Those emails are already in your database and those landing pages are already set up for you. It's just a matter of activating them. And if you wish to do that, I can have someone contact you to walk you through it. To be honest with you, one thing we have to take note, the UK process of getting approved for merchant accounts is not as advanced as Canada and USA. It takes a longer and they do require for more information. It's a process that we will help you through it, but it is a little bit more complex than the US process. For example, in USA it asks you like 5 questions and they give you a merchant account. UK is a little bit more different. So, but again, we know exactly the process. We can help you with that process if you wish. Ned has asked a very good question, which I don't believe I do know the answer to this, Ned. I do apologize. I'm writing down your name so I can give that answer for you. You have asked, will change to one family member address change it to all family members, or should only be address under the family be used on the master address? I would use the family address as a master address, but and I don't believe the change on one will make the change on all, but you know what? I will double check on that, and I will get back to you on it. I just don't want to give you the wrong answer. I have a guess, but I don't want to make that assumption until I have confirmation from our development team. Mr. Briscoe has asked, is it possible to use PayPal? Not at this time, but in 2015, we are doing integration to PayPal as well. So Eventually, yes. You are able to actually use PayPal as your billing option as well. We've had some people request it. It's not the most ideal situation since it's more expensive, but we are in development process. We've actually had a few talks with PayPal already, and we will have a partnership announced very soon, and hopefully that function available within 2015. All right. I believe I've answered all the questions. I'll give you guys a couple more minutes. You know, if you have any questions, type it down, so as you know, we can take this opportunity and this time to go over those questions. If not, then we can conclude the session for today. One note is this session has been recorded, and you know, will be shared within our social media accounts. You know, in the next few days, give us about a week for editing and all the alteration needed. And also, please, you know, visit our Facebook page. Our Facebook page, we include a lot of informative information. You know, we have weekly tips of how to utilize certain functions and features. We have videos for some of the features that we are releasing in addition to help files. The links will be going up on those pages as well. We have a great family feature, great video for the family enhancements. You can share that with your staff members or, you know, review it yourself if you want to get a refresher of how these tools work. And a lot of other interesting articles about, you know, improving your business and managing business. So please make sure you, you know, to stay active. Watch out for our news and posts. And we would appreciate if you like it and share them with your friends as well. And for those who are interested to see our rest of our webinars, you are able to essentially go to either one of our site champions, or PerfectMIND.com, and you would find the link for webinars on the bottom of the page. So here you go. And as you see here, sir, Mr. Briscoe, you see the recording of all the webinars that we've done in the past. All right. I've got a lot of good compliments. Thank you very much. Thank you guys for attending. And again, since we're not getting any questions, I'm just getting thank yous, and you're awesome, Nima. We can conclude the session for today. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact our support team, our 24-hour support team, through email, chat, or phone. Thank you very much.